Yeah, what's been your experience at gay bars?
It's not even pretty good. It's a safe space for me, at least.
Are you gay?
I'm not gay, no.
You're straight?
I'm straight, yeah.
Right, okay. And you feel safe at the gay bars?
I do.
Okay, cool. Interesting. Good to know.
Hi, I'm James Malcolm, and I'm the Taylor Swift of New Zealand comedy, mostly just because we both write about our ex-boyfriends. Safe spaces. They're places where queer people can feel loved and welcomed in a world that is often unaccepting and hostile. But recently, queer safe spaces have been crawling with straight people, which is making those safe spaces safe no more. It's time you straights learnt when your presence is and isn't welcome in queer spaces.
Hey Ray, thanks for joining me today. I'm here to talk about safe spaces.
Mm-hmm.
Exciting. Have you ever been to a gay bar, Ray?
Yes, and I felt really comfortable there, which I think a lot of people would say is the problem. This isn't funny, but I remember I took two female friends there, and I remember they got groped at a prominent Auckland gay bar. I remember being like, oh boy, yeah. I was very shocked that it happened there. I felt disappointed in myself that they were safe.
Mm. So I've made a little game for us today about safe spaces. I thought we could look at some celebrities and we could decide what we think their safe space might be.
Okay.
I thought we'd start, we've got Judith Collins.
Samoa.
Queen Elizabeth II.
Oh, funeral.
I feel like her safe space is like New Zealand. You know, she's really colonised it. She's sort of made it her own little sanctuary. Kia ora, Misty. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm kind of on the hunt for a bit of an expert on safe spaces. I was wondering if we could have a bit of chat about that.
For sure, yeah.
Awesome. And why are these spaces so important for the queer community?
I mean, historically, we have always struggled with safety, whether it be in our whānau and in schools and our jobs, wherever. So for some people, these safe spaces like clubs and whatever are their only spaces. And if they're not feeling safe there, then they have nowhere really.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. What is Jeff Bezos's safe space?
Anywhere.
Yeah, the whole world. he's fucking rich. He can do whatever he wants. He could buy a new safe space. Jacinda Ardern.
I'd say a Kiwi built house if she had made one.
Got the Briscoes lady?
No idea. I couldn't
think of one space. Yeah,
no. Maybe is there like a lady store? Maybe.
I'm out here on Karangahape Road where there's a bit of a protest going on about safe spaces. I'm here to see what it's about, and maybe we'll find some straight people along the way. Are you straight?
Yes.
And are you going to any gay bars tonight?
Yes, I am.
Why do you go to gay bars?
Because I love it.
Yeah?
I love dancing with them. Oh, yeah.
Have you ever picked up a guy at a gay bar before?
Yes. Yeah. My friend has.
Really? Can you tell me a little bit about what this protest is about?
Well, this protest is basically about fighting for our safe space because, historically, K-Rope belongs to the queers, right?
And why are safe spaces so important for the queer community?
Have you ever looked around? We're not welcome anywhere. We're not welcome in Queen Street. K Road is our street. This is our safe space. This is where we get to be ourselves and find ourselves.
I know there's been quite a few instances where straight men have gone to gay clubs to hit on lesbian or bi woman, which is why? I don't get it. But also they do bring in as a customer, as a patron, I guess they're putting their money where their mouths are and, supporting the queer scene, whether it be drag or just buying a drink or...
What would you say, what is your safe space?
Probably Tokyo Nintendo World.
Okay, and if we don't have the budget to take you there, where would you go then?
Well, one time I remember feeling really safe is when I was a five-year-old child, and I remember I'd felt scared, and my mum, and I remember her giving me a really warm embrace before she died.
Yeah, would you say you ever feel safe at a bowling alley, right?
I guess I wouldn't compare it to the love of a mother, but do you want to take me to a bowling alley? Does the TVNZ budget not stretch to Tokyo or bringing my mother back to life?
Mother's not dead.
Yeah, no, she's actually fine. Yeah, she's here stronger than ever.
I've brought you here to Pins Bowling Alley in Henderson so that you can have your own sort of safe space. I know you love bowling.
Yeah, this isn't normal.
What role do straight people have in like the destruction of these safe spaces for queer people?
Yeah. So I think primarily it's when they come in with predatory intentions. So if they're going in there to prey on straight women who go in there to feel safe from straight men, then that's absolutely disgusting behaviour and we don't want that.
Have you ever had straight people try and hit on you at a gay bar?
Tell them what happened!
One licked my back. It's like a flirting technique, a man, and it scared the shit out of me.
At a gay bar?
Oh yeah, he licked my back.
And how do you feel when you're in these safe spaces and you look around and you see like straight people, maybe a straight man who's like not being super respectful? Like, what is that? How does that impact on your enjoyment of the safe space?
I guess on a shallow end, it like kills the buzz, but also I feel like they tend to forget that the manuhiri, you know, the visitors in our spaces, you know, like, know your place, stay in your lane.
Yeah, totally.
But you can go there, have a gay old time.
Absolutely.
But yeah, be respectful of the people around you.
Cool.
In any space, not just queer spaces.
Absolutely.
Hey! Got a ball!
What's all this?
Well, I think just for you to enjoy your safe space, you still have to know what it's like to be oppressed. So I'm oppressing you right now.
It's sort of like I couldn't appreciate like the taste of chocolate. At least like say someone kicked me in the nuts.
I get it.
Yeah, okay.
That's okay. Right, another one, loser. And do you guys are out tonight, are you all straight?
Unfortunately, yes.
For the time being.
Yeah. Do you guys ever go out to gay bars and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. And what's the vibe?
It was better before everyone that wasn't gay went there.
Do you ever feel like though, and no judgment, do you ever feel like you're contributing to that in any way?
See, this is the thing because I'm a straight, as far as I know, person. I just think that I'm going there to support and have fun, but straight men going there looking for straight girls is not, in my opinion. I don't know.
Do straight people need to be doing like outwardly disrespectful things to make a safe space, to dilute the safe space or make it less safe?
I think so. If they're just there having a good time like everyone else, then there's no harm on anyone's behalf.
Okay.
I think it's as simple as not being a dick.
Yeah, great. It's a great lesson. It'll get you through a lot in life.
Yeah. And if you're if you happen to be a dick, then recognise and change.
Yeah, grow from it.
Yeah, exactly.
Cool.
Sort of make the space a bit more safe for you, right?
No, you're doing the exact opposite. This is humiliating.
Look at
Oh no.